Okay, where we left off in the first video. By the way, I'm recording them at the same time, so I still have the cold, and it's hard for me to speak for a long period of time. I make weird noises. I have to keep it short. So one thing I forgot to talk to you about in the first video is the first data structure of ELISP or any other LISP, which is really important. You might come across it in the source code, and you might find it really weird because there's no I guess there's similarities with other languages, but it's a different beast. You might find it really weird. And that thing is cons, right? Sorry. Basically, cons are a data structure in ELISP which are really which heavily used by everyone. They are the foundations of lists. Basically, you can do whatever you want with them. Most people use them. There are other type of data structure for creating collections, but cons are the most basic ones. Basically, it works like a pair of objects, right? So you create a con with cons function, give it two parameters, and it's going to give you a con, which is basically a pair, right? So if I do this, for example, right, you get an error saying that cons doesn't accept three arguments. It has to be two, right? So in order to get the first element, you have to use a function called char. I know it's weird. It is weird. It is a weird name, but it comes from Lisp itself. I don't know why they use char, and I don't care. All I care is that it's give me the first element in that count, right? So let's do this. My brightness is so low, I can't see what am I doing. Let me change my monitor's brightness. Okay. So now if I do this, as you can see in MiniBuffer, it returns one. The next function is CDR, which returns the second element, right? Pretty straightforward. Char, the first element, CDR, the second element. It's a pair, right? If you want to create a list, by the way, it already supports ELISP already supports LISP and lists and stuff like that, right? But since lots of people use cons for their libraries, and you may want to read a piece of code from other people, you might end up looking at weird functions for cons and try to get understand that snippet, and might have a hard time. I'm just giving you an idea of what is a con, right? So CDR returns the second element. If you're familiar with closure, it's like first and second, right? If you want to create a list out of cons, you can do something like this. For example, so basically you can create a linked list this way, right? First element and the second element in the pair is a pointer to the next element of the linked list, which is the same as using a con for the second element, since we don't have a pointer type of thing in ELISP, right? So Using this, you can do car B to get the first element, then do car CDR B to get the second element, car CDR again, get the third element. It's like a lambda type of thing. You can compose function to get to walk through the list, to walk through the linked list. That's one of the stuff I wanted to show you, just to avoid any confusion. There's tons of function in ELISP for manipulating the, to use lists and stuff like that, like map, map car, and filter, I guess, and lots of other stuff which you can find on the documentation. And I'm pretty sure if you come across any of them, you'll understand them in a blink of an eye because you know programming already. Yeah, that's it. That's what I missed to tell you in the first video. Till the next one.